Hey guys, welcome back to the show. I am your host, Jamie, and I'm really excited today to be chatting with you. I'm excited always to chat with you. I'm excited to have this platform to be able to share with you for you busy women who do not have the time to sit down and read a blog or even read an Instagram post. I'm really happy that I have this resource here for you to consume these quick and short bits of info, because I know that you might have these questions lingering in your head and not know where to get the answer, or just get not the correct answer. Not that I have all the answers, but I really just want to keep the information that I share with you very, very like simple, very back to basics, very concise and very consistent. Instead of getting these bits of info, a little bit from here, a little bit from there. And it can be frustrating getting all this different information, not knowing what to do or where to go to get you results. And that's all you're looking for, is to get results. So let's do just that. Before we move on, I just wanted to note that I really love all the questions coming through. They're really helpful for me to see. I see multiple questions of the same thing, so I really know that that is definitely content that I need to cover. So keep the questions coming. And the best way to leave a comment or question is to hop on over to the associated Facebook group called Healthy Weight Loss Tips for Busy Women, and you can leave me a question over there. You can also find me always at my website at www.ohowhealthy.com, or find me on social media at ohowhealthy. All right, so let's bring up today's episode. I want to talk about the idea of eating too many carbs, eating carbs, feeling guilty about having carbs. And I wanted to bring this up because right now, currently as you're listening, we are in a quarantine. You know, the COVID-19 situation is happening worldwide. And I know that a lot of my clients and listeners are struggling with overeating, eating at home, eating because they're bored, procrastinating eating, all these different stressors and triggers are coming up. And people are reaching out to me and saying, you know what, Jamie, I feel like I'm eating too many carbs. I'm not sure what to do. Can you please help? So I want to clear the air a bit about carbohydrates and break down some of these thoughts that we have about it, because not all carbohydrates are created equally. And some carbohydrates can be very beneficial for you. They provide energy, they provide stamina, they're good for your brain health. And then other carbohydrates are not so great for you. So we're going to break that down in this episode. So if you feel like, if you're in the situation where you feel like you're overeating, eating too many carbs, not only tune into this episode, but in the past couple episodes, I talked about some ways to overcome those struggles that we're all unfortunately experiencing at the moment. So I hope that you are doing well, staying well, and I hope that this episode helps. All right, so I first wanted to say that it's really not uncommon to hear negative things being thrown around about carbs. Immediately when we think about weight loss, we think, oh, I got to cut out these carbs and it's going to be horrible. It's going to be restrictive. I'm going to be starving all the time. I'm going to be moody. And you don't have to feel that way and do those things in order to lose weight or maintain your weight for that matter. And I also wanted to note that I'm not saying that going carb-free or restricting your carbs is not beneficial. It can be beneficial to some people in some occasions. It's just not the only way to get the results you're looking for. And also, I'm all about finding you the practical preventative solution to get you where you want to be and make it a lifelong journey, instead of, oh crap, I'm in the situation now where I gained all this weight and I feel like crap, and now I have to do this in order to improve my health and feel better about myself. And the thing of it is that there's always going to be birthday parties. There's always going to be wine nights. There's always going to be pizza nights. There's always going to be parties and events. And sure, like I'm saying, you could go to those parties. You could be that person that's bringing your own food or not eating at the party or making your, you know, not enjoying life and not enjoying food. And that's sure one way to live. But I want to tell you that there is a much less restrictive way to eat. There's a much less overwhelming way to live and eat. And it's not necessarily by going no carb or no sugar. I'm going to share with you some tips about to clear up this whole like no carb thing. I talked about sugar in my last podcast. So if you want more info on that, go ahead and listen to the last episode. And I'll also link that episode below. But I wanted to talk to today a little bit about carbs, because like I said, this is not something new that I'm hearing. I hear it a lot from a lot of different people, and especially with the whole keto trend going on right now, who know, like, you know, people just assume like, okay, obviously carbs are bad. Everyone's doing keto. I should be doing keto. But the thing is that the same diet that works for one person is not going to work for another person necessarily. That's exactly why, you know, that one diet that got your friend to lose X amount of weight cause you to bloat like a puffer fish. There's a reason for that. We're all so unique and individualized. But furthermore, I want to teach you, and my goal was to really show you that there's a way to live outside of dieting. And I'm going to talk to you a little bit about it today in the sense of carbohydrates and how and why you don't have to go carb free to be healthy and fit and look the way you want in a bathing suit. So when it comes to carbohydrates, there are two different kinds of carbs. There's simple carbs, which are also known as refined carbs, and complex carbs, carbohydrates. And when you want to lose weight, when you're trying to lose weight, it's not about cutting all carbs out, because not all carbs are evil, right? Evil in quotation marks. Because guess what? A vegetable is a carbohydrate too. Some have more carbs in them than other. But when you're going super low carb or keto, you're eliminating important nutrients and vitamins and essential food to your diet. You're not really even allowed to have fruit or vegetables. Like, veggies and fruits have so many beautiful vitamins and minerals in them, and you're just cutting them out. So think about it. Like, this is how I think about it. Why would I want to eliminate these beautiful, colorful, fresh, comes from nature food out of my diet and supplement that with lots of animal meat, lots of processed dairy? And so, like, when I think about it, I just think about it in like very simple terms like that. Like, well, what do I think my body really wants? Does that sound right to me? Does eating a crap ton of mayo and chicken and cheese and cream cheese and bacon, does that sound like something that I should solely be fueling my body off of? Like, these very high inflammatory foods that aren't getting balanced out with any other nutrient dense foods, like beautiful fruits and veggies and grains and nuts and seeds and all these other beautiful, beautiful foods. So anyway, that's just the way that I kind of think about it, like what just makes sense to me. So anyway, that was, when it comes to weight loss, you want to limit your intake of simple carbohydrates. So the simple one, so there's simple, which is also known as refined carbohydrates. And then there's complex carbohydrates. So think about it like simple is something that simply, like, quickly moves through your body, spikes your blood sugar really fast. And then the complex carbs, think of it like it takes time. There's more to them and they run more efficiently through your body and keep your blood sugar nice and stable. What we want to limit, not even eliminate, I don't like to use the word eliminate or don't have or no, because again, that's not life. And as soon as you say it, you're going to want it. So don't say no to yourself. But you want to limit your intake of simple carbohydrates. They are foods like donuts and cereal and candy and soda and, you know, the pastries and French fries and even items like, you know, most packaged processed foods. Whatever is made with white refined flour would be considered a simple carbohydrate food. So it's typically those really unhealthy foods, which honestly, when people eliminate carbs from their diet, they're eliminating a lot of this crappy food that they eat, a lot of the cookies and chips and candies and things like that, which obviously is going to help you lose weight. But you don't have to eliminate all of the carbs. So the complex carbohydrates, on the other hand, are foods you want to incorporate. And they are foods like beans and veggies and quinoa and oatmeal. And these foods are really great because, like I said, they balance your blood sugar. They provide you with lots of vitamins and nutrients that will keep your blood sugar low and stable. And these foods also keep you full and nourished longer. So yes, guys, you can let out a huge sigh of relief knowing that you don't have to give up carbs in order to live a healthy and fit lifestyle. These foods, these complex carbohydrates are actually really great for you. They're great to provide you energy. You know, if you're working out, they give you stamina, they give you mental clarity, and they're providing your body with essential vitamins and nutrients. So you want to get these items into your diet, guys. And the goal is to really create a well-balanced meal. You don't just want to have carbohydrates as a meal. You don't just want to have protein or fat or veggies for a meal. You want to create a nice, well-balanced meal. And furthermore, you really just want to make sure you're eating, you know, check your serving size, make sure that your portions are correct so that you're not overeating, because that could also lead to gaining weight, and you might be thinking that it's the carbohydrates' fault, but really it's not so much the carbohydrates, but sometimes we overeat the sizes of food and items that we get out, whether it's at a restaurant, whether it's a package of something we pick up, the serving size is usually 2, maybe 3 per whatever it is. But, you know, the serving sizes have grown substantially in the past 10, 20 years. When you go out to a restaurant, I mean, that meal that you get out is really enough for 2 to 3 people. And we're eating that ourselves and then getting dessert afterwards. So we pick out these individual things. We say, you know what? It must be the sugar. It must be the carbs, right? It must be the carbs that are making me fat. But it's a collective thing. It's a collective process of eating the wrong things, eating too much of whatever it is that we're eating, and not moving enough. You're a well-oiled machine, guys. You just need to find a nice balanced spot with all of this. It doesn't mean cut out the sugar. It doesn't mean cut out the carbs. It doesn't mean cut out the fats. So I really want to shift your paradigm in not thinking that way so much, and instead just incorporate really these beautiful whole foods into your lifestyle in a really simple and easy way. You know, create well-balanced meals and make sure our portion sizes are okay. So that was really it for me, everyone. I hope that this was helpful. Again, I'm going to create a thread in my Facebook group, the Busy to Balanced group for women, so we can talk more about this. And also, I wanted to quickly let you know that my membership site, Oh How Healthy Insiders, is celebrating 1 year of helping busy families simplify healthy eating so that it can fit into their busy schedule and their budget. So if you want to celebrate with us, we're doing it over in a Facebook party, in a Facebook group, and you're invited. There's going to be lots of giveaways, cooking demos, recipes, grocery lists, and so much more. So check out the link in my bio to join. All right, guys, have a great rest of your day, and I'll catch you in the next episode.